Connections Between World Leaders by Fritz Springmeier. Connections of the Hidden Hand. What if I were to tell you that bankers, royalty, communists, Nazis, future ones, occultists, and other important folks all quietly got together at a conference put on by Luciferians, the OTO and the Theosophical Society, held in Switzerland on August 15 through 25, 1917, prior to the October 19-17 Russian Revolution and the January 19, 1919 founding of the Nazi Party. Yeah, buddy. The name of the conference was a National Congress for Organizing the Reconstruction of Society on Practical Cooperative Lines. This conference was held near the southern Swiss town of Ascona, which sits on Lake Maggiore on a mountain called Monte Veritas. The place contains dozens of buildings and Luciferian and pagan temples. The OTO sponsored the Ascona Conference, and their conference program carried on its front page the slogan, "Do what thou wilt shall be the whole of the law." Theosophical Society. The Theosophical Society has included Illuminati members and key historical figures including H.P.B. Helena Blavatsky, Anne Besant, Alice Bailey, founder of over 100 New Age groups and established modern United States education, Manly P. Hall, Adolf Hitler, Mahatma Gandhi, and many others. Around 1900, the Society established a Theosophical Monastery at Monte Monesia, which they renamed Monte Verita, Mountain of Truth. It's in the Swiss canton of Ticino where Italian is spoken. Interestingly, the Visconti family, which I exposed, influenced this area after 1400 AD. Anyway, the monastery was a commune where free sex, nudism, occultism, socialism, and vegetarianism was practiced. Fidus created Luciferian temples, which he planned to replicate when Hitler won the next war. Freemason Theodore Royce built his Verita Mystica, VM, OTO Lodge at the monastery also. OTO. There are four organizations that carry this name. The most powerful one is a distillation of Illuminati occult power, as you will see later when I name some of the attendees. OTO members who attended this conference include Isadora Duncan, an American from San Francisco, Franz Hartmann, Rudolf von Leben, Gustav Nagel, Rudolf Steiner, Freemason and founder of Anthroposophy, and Theodore Royce. Communists and anarchists at the conference. The socialist Raphael Friedeberg was on hand to welcome the communists. Even though Lenin was supposedly in Finland, he and Trotsky were actually at this conference. So was Michael Bakunin and his friends. Bakunin had butted heads with Karl Marx. All these men had studied Hegel. To continue, Hugo Ball, the anarchist founder of Dadaism, Ernst Toller, founder and president of the Bavarian Socialist Republic, Eric Musum, and Frieda and Else von Richthofen. Future Nazis at the conference attended, Baron Eduard von der Haidt, banker, Stefan George, an occultist and theosophist who created lots of Nazi theory, including the 1,000-year Reich, Fidus, Hugo R.K.J. Hoppener, and last on my list, but not least, Rudolf von Sebottendorf, 1875 through 1945. Von Sebottendorf, born Adam Glower, was a major player in the creation of the Nazi Party. He joined the Germanen Order and then created an offshoot, the Thule Society, whose membership looks like a who's who of the future Nazi Party. Members of the Thule Society created the German Workers' Party in January 1919, and Hitler joined later that year and changed its name, which when abbreviated as Nazi. It's said von Sebottendorf trained Hitler. He was an occultist, theosophist, Sufi, and Freemason. Influential writers at the conference attended, Hermann Hesse, Franz Kafka, Erich Maria Remarque, and Leo Tolstoy Sick. Major psychologists at the conference attended, Otto Gross, who not only was a student of Freud, but influenced both Freud and Jung, and Carl Jung, who was led by the demon Philemon. Some other attendees of note attended, King Leopold II of Belgium, Queen Victoria's cousin and Illuminatus, Prince Wilhelm von Prussen, son of the German Emperor, Witch Mary Wigman, occultist Max Weber, Walter Siegel, a Jewish green architect, and Gustav Stresemann, a Freemason and Chancellor of the Weimar Republic. The Centennial Meeting at Ascona. Modern Times. After this meeting in 1917, Theosophists moved to California. In the 1960s, with help from the CIA, Theosophists recreated their Ascona lifestyle in California. This was the start of the hippie movement. Gypsy Boots, 1915-2004, is a Theosophist who is an example of this. He was promoted by bands and Hollywood. Hans Habe, an American intelligence agent in psychological warfare and Theosophist, moved to the Ascona Monastery. He, by the way, married the heiress of General Foods. In Ascona, Switzerland, the Museum of Modern Art displays the art of Paul Klee and Alexej von Jawlensky, both attendees of the 2017 Centennial Conference. These kinds of conferences have gone on throughout history. They are evidence of the Illuminati's hidden hand behind the events of history. While God remains ultimately in control, these people have sold their souls and minds to Lucifer. Now you know about the 1917 conference. What was its centennial like? 2017 OTO Ascona Conference. Who were the attendees at the OTO's conference held August 26, 2017, 100 years after the one I just exposed? In describing the centennial, I will mention obscure Luciferian types who the reader won't recognize. The Centennial Conference, also held at the Monte Verita Hotel, Ascona, was co-sponsored by the OTO Grand Lodge of Italy, Gran Loggia d'Italia, whose Grand Master Frater Fons X is an international traveler. Around 75 attended, mostly OTO members. The purpose of the conference in 2017 was vastly different than the first one. Just bear in mind how successful the first one was. In 2017 there were lots of academics, professors, giving scholarly talks on thelemic subjects. The lesson to us here is how much Luciferianism is now mainstreamed into the Western world's universities. One participant was Antifa activist Patricia Ebner. Musician. One attendee and speaker who was not a professor and academic was William Breeze, an American musician. He's the OTO's outer head, considered by some to be a Gnostic prophet. He joined his Gnostic Catholic Church to the OTO in 1986, and is head of the liturgical arm of the OTO. His title is Sovereign Patriarch of Ecclesia Gnostics Catholics. His Catholic Church is outright Luciferian. Breeze has at least two occult names, Hymenaeus Beta and Tau Silenus. Scandinavian attendees include Henrik Bajan and Chris Judici, who are both OTO members and professors at the University of Gothenburg, Sweden. Then there was Jesper Asgard Petersen, a Danish professor at NTNU. Another attendee was feminist Manon Hedenborg, a professor at Karlstadt University, Sweden. Other European attendees include speaker Marco Passo, a Hermetic philosopher and professor at the University of Amsterdam, and the Italian professor and occult dancer, Silvia Berti, from the Sapienza University, Rome, Italy. Some North American attendees, Gorda Jurjevic, OTO, immigrant to Canada, occult author, professor at the University of British Columbia, Stephen J. King, OTO, Keith Cantu, OTO, professor in California and Washington, Richard Kaczynski, American writer said to be the world's leading expert on Crowley, and William Peters, OTO. I've written several times on the OTO, bear in mind Scientology has connections to the OTO. Also noteworthy, although he was not an attendee, Jack Parsons of the Jet Propulsion Laboratory was OTO. From Australia came the famous artist Robert Baratti. An Aleister Crowley fan like the other attendees. The OTO has had lodges in Australia, as well as the United Kingdom, three sites being in Bristol, Hastings, and Leeds. I'd have to spend more time to give a more comprehensive list of their lodges. One of the meeting slogans was "Love is the law, love under will." As pointed out, attendees have looked up to Crowley, and often were teachers in higher education. More connections. As I said, many other meetings like the 1917 conference have taken place. Let's describe two other historical events that are slightly reminiscent of the 1917 Ascona Conference put on by the Luciferians of the OTO and the Theosophical Society. A gathering. This gathering happened in Vienna in 1913 during the reign of the elite Habsburg bloodline. It's an interesting historical situation that Hitler, Stalin, Trotsky, and Freud all lived in the inner city, Innenstadt, of Vienna, basically a 2-square-mile area. We know that Stalin and Trotsky spent time together. We know that Hitler and Trotsky hung out at the same coffee shop, Café Central, Herrengasse 14, and Freud's coffee shop, Café Landmann, Universitätsring 4, was just a short walk to the northeast across from the Rathaus that Hitler painted. Perhaps while painting across the street, Hitler took a break and also went into Café Landmann. Additionally, Tito was working just to the south of all this. The Viennese intellectual community. Charles Emerson, part of the elite, Illuminati, Chatham House wrote, "The Viennese intellectual community was actually quite small and everyone knew each other." James H. Billington, a top historian, described how the French Revolution was planned in Paris coffee shops. See fire in the minds of men. In the mornings, Hitler would read the papers and discuss politics with others who lived in his large dorm. No doubt he talked the same subjects later in the coffee shop Café Central. Hitler in 1913. Hitler, when he lived in Vienna, showed no signs of what he became later. At this period in his life, he associated almost exclusively with Jews, and bear in mind that Stalin, Trotsky, and Freud were all Jews. Hitler's business partners at this time were two Jews, Samuel Morgenstern and Jacob Altenburg. His friends were Joseph Neumann, Simon Robinson, Siegfried Laufner, and perhaps Reinhard Hanisch, all Jews. So it would be consistent with who he associated with if he'd talked to Trotsky and Freud. Jacob Altenburg, who saw Adolf Hitler basically all the time during this Vienna time period, said he'd never heard Hitler utter an anti-Semitic remark. This is different than what Hitler's ghost-written book Mein Kampf says about these days, which makes out like he already hated Jews. Hitler mentioned to Nazi historian Peter John in 1937 that his partner and friend Morgenstern had been his financial savior. We are being misled about Hitler's real life. I brought out in my Bloodlines of the Illuminati book that Hitler was a bastard Rothschild due to his grandmother being impregnated by one of them as a Rothschild servant. Where they lived. Hitler, then 24 years old, lived at a large, modern dorm on Meldermannstrasse Vienna. Freud lived and worked on Berggasse Vienna. Tito worked at the Daimler's auto factory at Wiener Neustadt Vienna. And Emperor Franz Joseph lived nearby in Hofburg Palace Vienna. By the way, Hitler walked all over the inner city painting all the interesting buildings including churches like Michael Kirche, Karls Kirche, Skottenkirche, and Kirche Maria am Gestad. Second event. There was an Italian aristocrat who claimed he'd eaten a child and who lived a debauched life named Gabriel D'Annunzio who started in 1919 a number of communes in and around Fiume that remind me of the Ascona Switzerland commune. Actually, Ascona is not far from Fiume. Gabriel D'Annunzio, 1863 through 1938, was the role model and personal advisor to Benito Mussolini. D'Annunzio was the head of the city-state of Fiume from 1920 through 24. Mussolini copied his style of leadership, for instance, balcony addresses to the people, the Roman salute, and having one's personal bodyguard unit wear black shirts. D'Annunzio. In 1910, he collaborated with French composer Claude Debussy, leader of the Priory of Zion and member of the Illuminati's Merovingian bloodline on a musical play. For several years he lived with his girlfriend Gabby DuPont. He used cocaine. As Fiume's dictator, his constitution states that the state does not recognize the ownership of property as a personal right. That's right, his communes had all kinds of sex and no ownership of property. The logo of his nation, the Italian Regency of Carnaro, also known as Fiume, was the Illuminati Ouroboros, a snake swallowing its own tail. Decadent art. D'Annunzio was part of the decadent art movement, which began in the late 19th century. It was fascinated with death, material excess, the bizarre, with self-disgust, perversion, and general skepticism. Most of the early Italian decadent artists died of suicide, alcohol, or disease. People reacted to D'Annunzio either as a revolting, decadent, and depraved person perverting public morals or as a liberator bringing fresh air to society. I have to wonder what, if any, was D'Annunzio's connection to the OTO and the Theosophical Society. They seem to be birds of a feather. There you have it, two intriguing scenarios to excite the researcher's curiosity. What lies beneath the facts I can provide you? Where was the hidden hand in all this? Published by Fritz Springmeier on May 13, 2023 at https://pentrax.com/connections-between-world-leaders.